Good morning students, welcome to Model Science class. Today we are going to start chapter number 11, Be Socially Useful. Before starting the chapter, let us find out the meaning of socially useful. Socially useful means when a person's acts are for the well-being of the society. When he is doing some acts which are very useful for the society. That is the meaning of socially useful. So first read out the chapter. Once, a king wanted to know how much his countrymen contribute to the social well-being. Disguising himself as a tramp, he moved out to a village before the dawn. Some of his guards also had accompanied him, posing as different people. So, once upon a time, there was a king who wanted to know about his countrymen. His countrymen means the people who are living in his kingdom. About how they are, what is their contribution for the well-being. Disguising himself as a tramp. So what he did, he disguised himself as a tramp. Tramp means person who move from one place to another on foot, like by walking. So what he did, he disguised himself as a tramp and went outside with his guards. On reaching the main road in the village, the king asked his soldiers to roll a big stone to the middle of the road and he placed an envelope under the stone. Then they moved aside and sat under a tree. So on reaching the main road, what they did? He asked his guards to put a big stone on the middle of the road. And after that, they hid under a tree. And what was the purpose of that? They just wanted to see the reaction of the people, what people will do. The king wanted to observe how the people react. As the day dawned, villagers started moving up and down the road. All of them were surprised to see the stone and were quite unhappy that such a big stone was in the middle of the road, obstructing their travel. So as the sun rose, dawn means early morning. So as the sun rose, people started moving from one place to another. And they were very surprised to see that a big stone is lying on the middle of the road. But what they did? They were just surprised and they were just blaming each other by that this stone is obstructing the road, but they did not do anything to move that stone. Some people complained aloud, some cursed, but no one thought of rolling the stone to the side of the road and making the road free to travel. So some people complained to each other, they just cursed each other that there is a stone lying on the road, but they did not do anything to move that stone to the side of the road. Some people said, we give heavy taxes to the king's treasury, but the king is not interested in giving us what we need. They were not aware that the king was listening to all their reactions. So what they did, some of the people, they blamed king also. What they were saying, they said, we are paying heavy taxes, but king is not at all interested in our well-being. And they were not aware that the king is listening to them. The king was disappointed to see that none of them was interested in clearing the path. However, he thought of waiting a bit longer. So seeing all this, the king was very much disappointed. He thought that no one is interested in clearing the path. They are blaming me, but no one is interested in doing the social work for other people. However, he thought of waiting a bit longer. He thought, okay, let us wait for a bit. As he was thinking about his people, there came a farmer with his horse. Seeing the stone, he stopped and dismounted. He knew the stone will hinder the free movements of the people and their vehicles. As he was thinking about the people that no one is doing anything, there came a farmer. A farmer came with a horse. After seeing the stone on the road, he was surprised. He stopped and what he did? With the help of his horse, he moved that big stone to the side of the road. As the stone was moved, he saw the envelope and picked it up. Seeing the royal seal on it, though bewildered, he opened it. And what he found under the stone? He found an envelope with a royal seal on it. He was very surprised to see that, but still he opened it. To his greater surprise, he found a handful of gold coins along with a letter. So what he found inside that letter, in that envelope, he found a handful of gold coins in it. And there was a letter also. What does that letter read? Let us find out. This is my gift for the one who thought of doing this social service without being told to do and without expecting anything in return for the work. So the letter read that it is a gift for the person who did this social work. What was the social work done? Social work done was to move that stone from the middle of the road to the side of the road so that other people can move freely. And what was the gift? That gift was handful of gold coins. The king was so happy that there was someone who thought differently. And after saying this, the king was so happy that at least there are some people who are thinking about others, who are thinking about the benefit of others. So this is a story. And what is the moral of the story? The moral of the story is that we should do good to others without any expectations and without anyone asking to do so. Next, our learning, do good even when no one is observing you. Yes, we should do good to others when no one is observing us. We should not think, okay, if anybody is looking at us, then only we should do good to others. Without any observance, we should do good. Next, do good even when there is no apparent reward for it. We should not expect any reward for doing good. Without any expectations, we should do good. Do good even if it consumes your time. Yes, we should not think about the time that if we are doing something good, some good act, it will consume our time. We should not think about the time. Do good even if it demands an extra effort from you. Yes, if we are giving some extra effort to do good, we should do the good after that also. We should not think that, okay, we have to do some extra effort for that. We can do. It takes courage to think differently. Moving with the crowd is easy, but standing alone for something that is socially useful is difficult and it demands courage. Yes, we should do things differently. We should not think that if someone is not doing good, we should also not do good. We should think different from others so that we can be an inspiration to others. When we give priority to the needs of the society and are willing to sacrifice our time and comfort, then we can bring a visible change in the society. We should not think about others that they should initiate for good things. We should take first step. We should not think about others. We should not wait for others that they should first they will move, then only we have to do good things. If we are willing to do, we should not think about others. We should initiate to do good things. So children, this was the chapter, and you can read out the chapter once again for the homework. So your homework is
thank you class. This is what you want to say to us.